Welcome to the second part of the series on blended learning. Previously, we have learnt about the concept of blended learning, which is a combination of face-to-face and online learning. We have also seen its models. In this video, we will learn how blended learning is applied or implemented in inclusive classrooms. This strategy is useful in inclusive education as it provides stimulation to more than one sense organ, thus catering to the diverse needs of students. The application of blended learning in inclusive classrooms requires support from all stakeholders, starting from the management. This is because blended learning requires funding, as many digital and electronic devices requiring human resources are involved in the application of blended learning. Thus, planning and implementation are the key terms to be followed during its application. Let's discuss what needs to be planned for using blended learning in an inclusive classroom. Blended learning can be used by having students work individually, in pairs, or in groups. These are different strategies. So, the teacher needs to plan which of these strategies will be used. The teacher also needs to plan for the timeline or how long it will be used for. That is, for how many classes will blended learning be used? Planning also requires to be done regarding which of the four instructional models of blended learning will be used. Remember, we have learned about these four models in the previous video? Yes. So, the teacher has to select which of those models will be used and also for which student according to their needs. The teacher has to choose the content and which platform the students will be comfortable to use. For example, using blogs or chats, etc. for interacting with the class. Then the teacher needs to plan which device will be used. For example, will students be using computers, tablets, or mobile phones during the online sessions? The online sessions will require well-trained teachers who are capable to handle online and electrical devices. Hence, staffing and development, that is their training, too needs to be planned. Once the planning is done, next comes the implementation. The school should be well equipped with proper online infrastructure and connectivity. That's the soul of online learning. Integration of the content in the form of traditional instruction and online instructions has to be done smoothly. Continuous training and professional development of teachers and special teachers need to be done so that they can supervise and help the students with disabilities using these devices effectively. While using blended learning, teachers need to get support from technicians like tech support, or they could be computer engineers for support as support staff. This is required if there are any technical problems that need to be solved during the online sessions. Communication channel should be flexible and open in blended learning. Students should be encouraged to choose their mode of communication. This is beneficial for students who are unable to speak, as they can use text to communicate with classmates using chats or blogs. Finally, during measurement or assessment of learning, the teacher should take into consideration the aims of the lesson. Assessment not only focuses on the content learnt, but also if the students have become independent learners. While doing so, the teacher needs to have realistic expectations regarding students with disabilities. The teacher should be clear while giving online assessments and assignments. Instructions should be detailed in order to avoid confusion in the minds of these differently abled students. Blended learning can be used while planning the IEP or individual education program. But there are some precautions that teachers need to take while using blended learning for students with disabilities. Some of these general precautions are that the teacher needs to select the appropriate assistive device which caters to the need of that particular challenge, and hence the teacher should be clear about what the student can do as well as what the student is not able to do. The students will require practice and training to use different software or hardware devices. This is important for the students who are typically developed, and more so for students who are having some kind of challenge or disability. Special attention also should be paid to the quality of audio and video, which needs to be excellent. Specifically, there are certain things the teachers should take care of while dealing with students with disabilities in blended learning settings. Let's look at a few of them. We start with the students with hearing impairment or students who are hard of hearing. For students who are mildly or moderately hearing impaired, that means they can hear a little bit. They're not able to hear completely, but they can hear a little bit. Any type of white noise or background noise that might affect the audio of the content should be totally removed so that there is no disturbance in the audio. Some of these students may depend on lip reading, so the faces in the video must always be visible to the students. For students who are severely hearing impaired, that means they cannot hear at all, visual inputs should be clear. Hence, the lighting should be appropriate so that it is clearly visible. In case of video which has commentary, subtitles which are in clear and appropriate font sizes and fonts should be included. If required, additional visual inputs like pictures or diagrams or even graphic organizers should be added. For the visually impaired students, especially those who are mildly or moderately visually challenged, the teacher should take care of these things. First and foremost, remove visual clutter. That is, the screen should not have too much of clutter. This is because if there are too many objects in one picture or too many pictures on a PPT slide or too much of content, then the student will have difficulty in seeing the main content. So the whatever visual inputs are there, they should not have too much of clutter. For some students with visual impairment, the font size needs to be larger than those used for the typically developed students. Again, the lighting needs to be adjusted. Here, the seating arrangement of the students in the classroom too can be adjusted. For example, while showing videos, the teacher could make students with visual challenges sit near the screen. Additional audio inputs will be required for students who are totally blind. It could be in the form of a verbal commentary of things that are happening in the background along with the dialogues in the video. Let's go on for the precautions that the teacher needs to take for the physically challenged students. For the physically challenged students or students with physical disabilities, the teacher needs to select such assistive devices that the student can access without having to move around too much, whether in the classroom or in the school premises. Some of these students have medical or health issues. Hence, while planning blended learning, the teacher needs to keep in mind how long they will have the stamina to complete the online tasks. Also, these students may have difficulties with gross motor or even fine motor skills like typing or writing. They may also have difficulty in moving the upper parts of the body like students with cerebral palsy. These two need to be taken into consideration while planning the activities used in blended learning. The teachers could also pair students with a buddy or conduct pair work where these students may be paired with a peer who can help them while taking down notes or doing physical activities which they need assistance with. Students should always be given the opportunities to try different learning experiences irrespective of their challenges. We move on to another type of challenge related to social skills. While using blended learning for students with autism spectrum disorder, care should be taken to prepare them for changes in their regular classroom sessions. Remember, these students find it very difficult to adjust to sudden changes. Hence, they need to be prepared and gradually incorporate the change from traditional classroom teaching to online teaching. The audio and visual inputs need to be subtle. Sudden sounds or sudden visuals could be disturbing for these students. Hence, care should be taken with the volume level. As far as possible, these students need to be constantly supervised and accompanied by a teacher during the online sessions. Detailed instructions are given for communication. Since communicating is a challenge for these students, they need to know how students and teachers will be communicating. For example, through text, like chats or audio calls. There are some interesting blogs by teachers that I came across. These are teachers who have used blended learning with these students who have autism spectrum disorder. They noted that these students interacted very freely with the whole class using chat rooms. Can you imagine? Because it did not require face-to-face interaction. See, we know that these students find it difficult to maintain eye contacts and have face-to-face conversations. So blended learning can be an effective way to get active participation of these students during discussions. Blended learning actually has many advantages of being used in an inclusive classroom. Let's have a look at some of these advantages. The first advantage is that it enables the teacher to cater to the diverse needs of the students as different multimedia devices can be used. Also, the teacher can connect with all learners at various levels. For example, as we just saw about students with autism spectrum disorder. There is flexibility to choose from various resources, which makes the teaching learning more interactive and interesting. And of course, There is a variety of assessments that can be done using all these devices. Students are exposed to instructions that support their learning style, diverse abilities, and background. Hence, all kinds of students, including the differently abled students, are more likely to experience success in a blended learning classroom. Among these interesting references that I came across while preparing the content of this video, the first one is really informative. It discusses how blended learning is to be used while dealing with 10 types of children with disabilities. I really recommend you visit the site for additional reading, as we have discussed about 4 types of children or students with disabilities. I hope you liked the video and have understood how blended learning can be implemented in a classroom. Thank you so much for watching this video.